Let's take a look at sine rule. In sine rule, it is a formula where we establish relationship between angles and sides of a triangle. Take for instance, this is A, angle A, angle B, angle C. The sides opposite to this angle, we call it small a. Side opposite to this angle, we call it small b. Side opposite to this angle, we call it small c. Now, sine rule help us to create a relationship where we could find the angle or side. So this is the formula. In sine rule, we say small a over sine a is the same thing as b over sine b is the same thing as c over sine c. So let's take a look at a quick problem. So here I'm asked to find x here. So as I already said that using sine rule, we are able to find sides or angle in a triangle that is not a right angle. So from here, let's establish the relationship. We can say that small x is the same thing as small c because it is opposite to c. So let's say this is small a. Small a over sine a equals small b over sine b equals small c over sine c. In this question, we are told to find x, so we can basically do away with the b part and say a is giving us 6.73 over sine a equals c, which is the same thing as x, over sine c, 82. Now let's find for a plus 39 plus 82 is 180. That is sum of angles in a triangle. So we can say that a equals 180 minus 39 plus 82 degrees. This will be a equals to 180 minus 121 and a equals 59. So we can bring that to the formula a equals sine a equals c over sine 82. So a that is 6.73 over sine 59 equals c over sine 82. By cross multiplying, we have this times this, that will be 66.73 times sine 82 equals this times this, sine 59 times c. Now from here, we can simply make c to stand alone by dividing both sides by sine of 59, sine of 59, such that this will cancel out and we have c equals to 6.73 times sine 82 over sine 59. Punching this in a calculator, we have c equals 7.775 cm. Maybe to two decimal place, we could have 7.78 cm to two decimal place.